my loves. Right, so today I'm going to be showing you some items that I received from Lecenté, including some gels from their Create collection. I'm going to be swatching those off camera, but showing you the results, and also doing a design on my almond sculpted nails. I'll also show you all the other bits I got and explain them to you. Oh, it's like Christmas already again. So first of all, let's look at the removal wraps. Now, this might convert me because I've just been using tinfoil, and to be honest, it's a pickle and it's a mess. And when someone turns up and they say, actually, I want to soak off and I haven't got any already cut up, I've got to faff about. These just so easy, aren't they? It's really easy. They're beautifully tucked away in a box. You can pop them in your drawer. Nice and easy. So I think that might convert me. And if you turn the box over, all the details are on the back, including the size of the wraps. There's 100 wraps in a box, and they give you brief directions for use as well, which is very nice. And also their website information for additional information. They've sent me a cuticle tool here, which does have instructions on the back. Comes in a beautiful leatherette case. Obviously it's textured, it's got their logo on it, and that just flaps and closes down there. So if you're on the go, it's nice. It's got like, I think you would call it a beveled handle. It's like a textured handle, one chisel end and one scoop end. My cat's here, so if you can hear him purring, I do apologize. You probably can, because he's shoving his nose on the camera. Right, so I've also got their UV LED lamp, and it comes with multiple different power plug options. So we've got this one, you got this one, and then you've got the UK one as well. We've got full instructions. This is what the lamp looks like. It's got an AC/DC adapter with it, and then obviously our UK plug. The plug socket is in the back. It's very quick and easy to set up. There's also 10 seconds, 30, 60, and then a low heat 99 second timer at the back. I've also got the base coat, top coat from the Lecenté Create collection. They feel very bougie. The bottles feel bougie. I've got this colour, which is Portobello. They're all London names. It's really cool. So here's the colour. It's really beautiful. They're very luxurious feeling. Very nice. And then we've got Soho, which is a very deep blue, really gorgeous blue. It's almost slightly pearlescent, sheeny. I don't know, it's just gorgeous. Then there's this bright red called Carnaby, and it's really lustrous, gorgeous red. Sorry, I'm letting the dog in. Come on, Milo. Look at that, oh, stunning. Oh! Then there's this beautiful colour called Theatre Royale, which is really glittery and sparkly. It's almost like a rose gold. It's very beautiful. Then onto one I really, really love. I might use this in my next design, which is Oxford Circus. This is, I haven't got any colour like this. It's like a charcoal grey. It's absolutely gorgeous. Very nice. And this is them swatched on my little swatch sticks. I didn't want to swatch them like on camera because I want to do some design work with them. Also got these glitters. So Fairy Tale Super Hollow, which is a multi-mix. They all come with this plastic cover at the top, so I can show you the glitter without it spilling everywhere, which is great. And Super Rose Holographic. I think this is like a, not a super fine, but like a fine cut. Milo, stop being noisy. It's noisy today. Pearl Chunky, which is a really holographic silver. And I've got chunkier ones. I'd say this is mid-range on the chunky scale. And Golden White Iridescent, which is what we're going to use today, which is a, like a super fine. It's really beautiful. So I've already taken the lid off that one, as you can see, because I'm using that one today. Okay, well, I've already got my extensions on. I did those yesterday, so I'm just going to push the cuticles back and prep the area anyway, so the cuticles haven't encroached too much on the area. Test the tool out, see how it feels. We'll do that quickly, and then we'll get to work. So I'm going to apply base coat to all the nails. I'll show you one. The base coat is nice and thick. It reminds me of like these rubber base coats that I've seen. So it's almost like if you've got a slightly uneven surface, say you see a little divot or just something small, you could probably use that on there to smooth that surface out. It's really got a nice texture to it. They're all 30 second cure as well in the lamp, which is great. Right, so that's one done. I'll do the rest off camera. There we are, all done. Okay, so we're going in with the pink. I think it's Portobello first. And we're gonna do a whole nail of this. It's quite satisfying to watch, isn't it? And because I've got quite small nail beds, I'll actually go around the cuticle area with my detailer brush. Ooh, we're good, we never left the ground. But we need to take some weight off our shoulders. The fight isn't over. Can you let me be tonight? I will need some time alone, not forever, but when we're together. It feels like my spark's been left in the dark sometimes. Cause when I'm with you, it's just like an airway, better than a band-aid. This could be love, not sure, but I'm probably right. Then that will go in the lamp for 30 seconds. And we'll move on to the next nail. This is that beautiful blue. Oh. Very gorgeous colour. I'm going to do a cuff nail here. I'm doing it this way because I just fancied it. So I'm going to lay down the blue first. You could lay down the other colour first and then do the cuff this way around. But yeah, which whatever takes your fancy, I suppose. Great coverage. No bits. I mean, I've tried some gels before and they've even got bits in them. I was like, what's this? It's like painting with sand. These are beautiful and smooth and gorgeous. So 30 seconds in the lamp for that. It's those two. Next nail is going to be the pink again. So we'll do a full nail of that. And then we'll do the same cuff nail on the following finger. Righty ho. So I'm going to place a bit of this beautiful sparkly. I think this one's Theatre Royale. And pop that on there. Or Theatre Royal. I don't know why I said Royale. I think I'm trying to be exotic. Theatre Royale. Not Theatre Royal, mate, innit? Down the old apples and pears, bruv. So, I'm so funny. I just need to be put in a box for the night. I'm going to use my detailer brush and colour in these cuff areas. Could be a really nice negative space cuff now, actually. I've got loads of ideas because the coverage is good on these gels. It's like, oh, it's inspiring, isn't it? So you'll just see me filling in this little gap. Once that's done, I'll give it a quick zap in the lamp for like 10 seconds just to hold it in place while I do the other bits.
design. You like me too. We can take it slow, make sure we do this right. Canceled all my plans to be with you tonight. So just sit with me, talking to the night until the morning, building chemistry. I don't think I ever wanna go come closer next to me. Trying to find another way to say this, but I think we were meant to be.
Right, onto this finger. Now I'm going to use that beautiful blue color and I'm going to draw like a little leafy vine. It's just, it was in my head. There's no real reason. I just saw it in my head and thought, ooh. But once I looked at it on the replay doing this part, I thought, ooh, that would look good as a marble as well. You could marble that out with a little bit of isopropyl alcohol. So, yeah. Well, the options are endless when it comes to nail art, really. One thing leads to another, doesn't it? This led to a little vine nail, which has now led to me thinking about marble nails. I'll let you to watch this. I'm literally just going to pop little leaves here and there. There's no real kind of tight knit method of this. I'm not, you know, the best at freehand nail art anyway. Right, once that's cured in my lamp for 30 seconds, I'm going to go in with this beautiful glittery Theatre Royal again, or Theatre Royale, Riba, and fill in the little leaves with just a little drip of glitter, almost like magic frost in the mornings. I shall then cure it for 30 seconds and then go back over the cuffs again just to make sure they're all neat and tidy. Now onto the thumb, I'll do a base coat, cure that for 30 seconds, and I'm going to do two layers of Theatre Royale. I just want to say Theatre Royale every time now. Now, onto top coat. I top coated all the nails, but for some reason my camera stopped working. So I've got top coat of one of them, maybe two. But the pinky I top coated, and then we're going to sugar the nail with that beautiful golden white iridescent glitter. So I'll just do a nice layer of top coat and then sugar over the glitter, and we'll cure that. I'll top coat all the rest of the nails, and then I buffed the nail with the vine on it and went over with a matte top coat, which I had in my drawer, because I felt that it would just look so much better as a matte nail. So we're just going to go in. Oh, I did get it. I wondered if I got, I couldn't find this footage. It's okay. I was panicking. I thought that it hadn't recorded it earlier because it skipped when I was editing. That's brilliant. Right, so we're top coating. Fabulous. We are top coating, and I'm just checking the level of the nail, making sure it all looks good. Making sure I just gently cap that free edge. So yes, I will do this with the gloss top coat. And then I buffed it and went over with a matte top coat. Beautiful, beautiful top coat. Really nice. Again, that's the 30 second cure as well. And that's the video. Here's the finished design. I really hope you've liked it. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much to Lecenté for sending me these beautiful items. I'll see you in the next video. Tally bye!